Now I gotta get my ground, my train groundhog down in the hole and shovel out all the sawdust. That didn't do too bad. I know I did a little unconventional by spinning them around. Here's my eddy. You did good. I hope I'm still kicking at your age. Look at that. That's the boiler wood for next year. That'll go in my chunks and hunks pile over there. Nah, that can go in a regular, cut it off 16th inch. Oh, you got caught. Look at that. Did you want that other little piece? That had the heart in it. That's why I cut that out. Hi. Oh, you did get, I guess you got a couple of them. You get whatever you want.
I hate to see it go to waste, you know. I'll make a scratcher or a cane or something out of it.
You want to chop that up smaller?
No.
Okay. Why does white oak turn pink when it's cut?
Say that again?
Why does white oak turn pink? Look at it. It's pink. And then it'll go brown.
I can't answer that.
Well, what kind of sawyer are you? Look at that. You only needed one 4x4, or did we get two in there? You got one 4x4 and some 3/4 inch boards and some.
Well, I think the 3x3s are
more easy to work with
for making me up these joints. When we get, if we ever do another log, I might get some 3x4s, or maybe 2.5 by 4.5, or something like that.
Okay.
I'm going to make up a joint and see how it looks. You know.
Used to be able to have joints. Now they've made it all legal. You can have joints now.
If I make a barn joint out of that, mm-hmm. I'll need some lumber like that to make the tree nails, so the trunnels.
Trunnels? Is that what that?
That's the pin
that they call them trunnels?
Trunnels, tree nails, pins, whatever.
All right.
Depends on what part of the country you're from.
Well, that's kind of like submarine sandwiches and hoagies and, oh, they call them all different things. What's the real name for the part that goes up? Is that an L or is that a knee on a sawmill that the board goes against? Or does it depend?
The proper name is L, but it is a knee where you push something against it.
And is that,
I would say an L is more proper.
It answers it better, because if you look here, they're all L's. Mm-hmm. So anyhow, if you guys haven't seen back, a couple years ago, we did a couple real good videos of his machine shop. He can make anything. And in the summertime last year, or the summertime the year before, you made me some parts to help adjust this, and I used it, and then I decided it was too much trouble, and it's in the barn. But you know the bearings that hold the set shaft in the back? They were so out of line, I just took them off. I don't even have them on there. You know,
What have you got on there now? Where do they come from?
I don't have anything on there. There's nothing on the back of there that holds them. The beds, the bearing assembly in the bed holds it.
Okay. I know what you're talking about. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What do they just, if your beds are not bolted down, then you got to have them. Mm-hmm. But my beds are all bolted down. They got 1/2 inch, maybe 3/4 inch bolts on the front and the back. And I think I like that. Seems to work pretty good in and out. Guys, this is a maiden voyage if you weren't aware of it, if you're new here. And that's actually the first log, and I was with Mr. Billy Waters here. And he's the one that got me hooked on sawmills a long time ago. Actually, it was Arthur Stone, because Arthur Stone had the sawmill across from my uncle's house, mm-hmm. down on Lay Hill Road, when Lay Hill Road was just above a dirt path.
That goes back to about 1970.
Well, we're going back in the 50s. We're going back in the 50s.
When I first got to know you, you moved a couple millstones for me.
I don't remember. I remember a boiler.
Yeah.
It was down on 108.
Uh-huh.
That was a long time ago. That was in 78 or 79.
I'd already moved away from there. My parents still live there. But I had moved away from there in about 62, something like that. Anyway, so, you were at the Shell station in Damascus then.
Yeah, worked there. All right, well, we're going to wrap this one up. Hit the like button. Hit the subscribe button. If you want to see more goofy nonsense, hit the bell icon and you'll see it. Thanks for stopping by.